हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू youtube.com/DrVet चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पीआर पटेल, प्रोफेसर हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। हियर वी विल डिस्कस इम्पोर्टेंट बैक्टीरियल डिजीज बॉट्यूलिज्म एंड इन पार्ट 5 वी स्टडी द क्लिनिकल साइंस इन फोल, सीप, पिग एंड डॉग। द क्लिनिकल साइंस इन कैटल and horse we have seen in part 4. Here we discuss clinical science of botulism in foals. It is a toxico-infectious botulism in foals by type B toxin. The toxico-infectious means the organism are in the intestine and produce toxin there. So organism and toxin are in the same animal. That is called toxico-infectious botulism. Highest prevalence are observed in young foals up to 8 months of age. When toxic consumption is more, the foal manifests paracute symptoms. The foal may be found dead without any pre-monitory signs in paracute cases. In foals, the characteristic syndrome is observed is called as a Saker-Foal syndrome. Saker, here because of the shaking of the foal, the name is given Saker-Foal syndrome. Here there is multiplication of organism in the intestine and production of toxin in the intestine, and toxin is absorbed. The prominent early sign is the muscle tremor. So there is shaking of the foal, so Saker foal. And they exhibit a critical sign, that is progressive symmetric motor paralysis. The gait is tilted and stiffness. The affected foal is unable to stand for more than few minutes. There is dragging of the toes, drooling of saliva from the mouth. When the foal tries to suck the milk drools out from the mouth. There is difficulty in swallowing and eating because of the paralysis of the muscles. When foal try to eat the food is regurgitated through the nostril. The constipation is a consistent symptom and consistently occurring because of the stoppage of the movement of the GI tract. There is rapid progression to severe muscular weakness. The muscular weakness become more and more. Because of unable to eat and drink, there is loss of condition. Animal is unable to rise because of the paresis and paralysis. As the paresis and paralysis progresses, there is lateral recumbency, finally prostration of the animal. But the sensation, pair perception and brightness is maintained till the end of the life. There is mydriasis, dilatation of the pupil. There is complete sensation of peristaltic movement of the gastrointestinal tract manifested by constipation. Another important symptom is observed is frequent urination. There is effect on the bladder of the foal. The temperature of the body varies greatly from slightly elevated to depressed. there is severe dyspnea to such an extent that the animal has to extend the head and neck. There is respiratory arrest, tachycardia, and there is death of the foal in 1 or 2 days or 3 days after onset of the clinical signs. The death is due to respiratory failure because of the paralysis of the respiratory muscles. Friends, we discuss here clinical signs of botulism in SIP. The SIP clinical signs are little bit differ from the other animals. SIP do not show typical flaccid paralysis sign, but it will show the flaccid paralysis sign at the last stage of the disease. So here there is little bit differing from the other species. The early symptoms are, there is stiffness on walking, stiffness of gait, incoordination of the movement, and there is excitability in the initial stage of the botulism. In SIP, the condition is called limber neck. Also, limber neck type is observed in poultry also. Here, the SIP held the head on one side of the body. And while walking, the SIP makes a quick, short movement of the head up and down. It is a movement of the head up and down. That is called as head is bobbed up and down. This is the characteristic symptom of limber neck, and that is again due to paresis or paralysis of the neck muscles. There is lateral switching of the tail, again because of the paralysis. There is salivation, nasal discharge is serous. As the disease progresses, the paresis, paralysis, muscle weakness also progress. There is a paralysis of the thorax muscles. So, the SIP exhibits a terminal abdominal respiration. Finally, SIP goes to the limb paralysis, prostration, and rapid death due to respiratory failure. So, SIP exhibits the paresis and paralysis at the last stage of the disease. Initially there is excitation. So this is a little bit different between the SIP and the other species. The pigs are comparatively resistant and the reports on clinical signs are available very rare. The signs are similar to the other animals, but not much serious. Staggering of the gait, recumbency, vomiting, pupillary dilatation, flaccid paralysis of muscles, anorexia, and adipsia. Animal is unable to take water. So signs are nearly similar to the other animals, but not much serious, as the pigs are comparatively resistant. Here we discuss clinical signs of botulism in dogs. Dogs are also comparatively resistant. But when more consumption of botulism toxin at a time, then the dog develops symptoms very quickly. Within 12 to 36 hours, there is development of symptoms after ingestion of the botulinum toxin. There is generalized weakness. There is sequence of paralysis like this. First, there is paralysis from the hind limbs then paralysis move forward, and then there is a paralysis of the forelimb, then head and neck. In dog, there is paralysis of respiratory muscles, so there is great dyspnea is observed, increased respiratory effort, facial nerve paralysis, and that leads to difficulty in swallowing, and death occur due to respiratory failure. Friends, we have discussed here the clinical signs in foals, a very important terminology, Sakker-Foal syndrome, clinical signs in sheep, that is limber neck, pigs and dogs are comparatively resistant. Important information, please share to veterinarians and veterinary students, press like button. Subscribe the channel to promote the channel. Thank you very much for observing this video.